Hello students, welcome back to the online class of AIS. I am Sharmishtha Dash, your computer teacher. Today I am going to teach you introducing the internet and email. I am going to share the first PPT based on this chapter internet and email. In this PPT I am going to introduce few terms that you will come across while reading this chapter. So let's begin with the chapter 5, introducing the internet and email. The first thing that you will come across, that is the most important thing of your chapter, that is email. Email, the full form is electronic mail, that is the transmission of messages and files via computer network. So the main motto of email is to transmit the message and files via a computer network. The messages can be sent in form of simple text, or it can be sent in form of attachment such as documents, graphics, audio, video, etc. Internet access provider usually provide an email program. Some websites such as Hotmail, Yahoo, Gmail provide a free email services. You must have seen the email. The domain name. I have given one example here, samjohnson@scsite. So the username is Sam Johnson and the domain name is scsite.com. So in my email address also, my email address is sharmishtha.pinky@gmail.com. So the username is sharmishtha.pinky, whereas gmail.com is the domain name. So you must remember that the email address is a combination of two things. First the username, next the domain name. So let's move to the next slide, that is slide number 4. This is a drawing. The drawing based on how an email generally travels. See, first the source computer you can see, then the source computer will send the email. The email will be received by the outgoing mail server. Then it will be received to the internet routers. Then it will move on to the incoming mail server. Then it will move on to the POP3 server, and then it will move on to the destination computer. So if you are going to send me a mail, so first your computer will be acting as a source computer, then the email will be received by the outgoing mail server, then the internet routers, then incoming mail server, POP3 server, and the destination computer. In that case it will be my computer. So let's move on to the next slide, that is the fifth slide. Accessing an email. Now see, email clients are programs that allow you to send and receive emails. It on the basis of a smartphone. So let's move on to the next slide. The next slide is very important, that is the World Wide Web. In the previous slide only we were discussing regarding the website. So whenever you have typed one website address, you must have used the word www. The full form of it is World Wide Web. So World Wide Web, or simply web, is a collection of worldwide collection of electronic documents, web pages organized in a websites. It is mainly made up of three main parts. One is client, then the backbone internet cloud, then the server. So whenever you are going to search something in the website, website is nothing but it is a worldwide collection of documents, web pages, and that are being arranged into the websites. Let's move on to the next slide, that is the internet protocol. In protocol means rules. In internet also we are going to use a lot of protocol. So internet protocol is the most important protocol used on the internet. It specifies that the information sent between computer, servers and router must be broken down into small packets of data. Now in my next slide, I am going to discuss what do you mean by packets. Packets are small chunks of information. Whenever you are going to send me a mail, the message is generally broken down by the internet. While sending the email message from one computer to another, each packet contains the address of the destination computer. So if you are going to send me a mail, so the message will be the destination computer address. So here we come to the end of this PPT. Hope you understood. And in my next PPT, I will be showing you how to compose a mail, the different terms associated with a mail, that is CC, BCC, each and every details I will be sharing in the next PPT. Hope you understood. Thank you, students.